In this video, we will talk about rendering a project using a render engine called Cycles. It is implemented in various third-party apps, including Blender. The app is free. We have the download link under the video. Since Blender cannot open documents created in Live Home 3D, we will use the glTF format, which is supported by both apps. Before exporting your project, make sure that the current 3D view displays what you are going to render. Changing the point of view later in Blender might cause problems if your project contains 3D images, also known as sprites. If the project doesn't contain any 3D images, you can use multiple cameras in Live Home 3D and then in Blender. To export a model of the project, we open the menu, then select Export and Export 3D Objects. Now we select the glTF format. Both text and binary versions of this format would work. Let's choose binary, as it is more compact. Since we need to export the entire project, we select the Entire Project option. If we had a multi-story house, we could export a particular story. There's also an ability to select and export a single object. The lower part of the Export dialog box lets us set which of the auxiliary objects we want to export. We need to select Export Lights and switch off the rest. Finally, we save the file. Now it's time to switch to the Blender app. It opens up the splash screen by default. To close it, hit the Escape key. The default project contains three objects that we don't need. Let's remove them by pressing the A key to select them all. Then we press the X to delete. In order to import our project, we select File in the main menu, then Import, and choose the glTF format. After that, we navigate to our model file. Let's keep the default settings in the Import dialog box and click the Import button. Blender can render views defined by cameras, as we saw in Live Home 3D. All objects present in the project are listed in the outliner. To display the 3D view that we set up in Live Home 3D, we select the Main View camera in Outliner. Now we open the View menu, then Cameras, and select Set Active Object as Camera. By default, Blender activates the solid display mode. This is why most objects are gray. In this mode, rendering is very fast. It is helpful for creating new objects or rearranging them in the scene. We can choose other modes using the Viewport shading options in the upper right corner. Buttons farther to the right add more details. This one activates the Material Preview mode. The last is the Render mode. In this mode, Blender renders the scene with textures. If you turned on the Export Environment Panorama checkbox in the Export dialog box of Live Home 3D, then it's a good time to make use of the panorama texture. We click on the World Properties tab of the Properties panel, and then click on the yellow circle of the Color property. This brings up a menu where we need to choose Environment Texture. After that, we open the list of imported textures and select Environment Panorama. The default render engine is Eevee. We can choose the Cycles render engine in the Render tab. The Device option lets us choose GPU. If you have one, set it. GPU renders much faster than CPU. The 3D viewport displays various information in the upper left corner. That includes how many samples have already been rendered, followed by the total number of samples. Every time you change the point of view or edit the scene, Blender starts rendering again. If this number climbs to the maximum too slowly on your computer, you can click on the Pause Preview button in the upper right corner. I recommend you decrease the max samples values in the viewport section. Try 50. After a few renders, you'll see how quickly the viewport updates. And then adjust the value to make your work with the scene comfortable in the render mode. Just let me remind you that you can switch the viewport to other modes, which can update the view much faster. The max samples value in the render section defines the quality of renders. It can be many times greater than for the viewport. To start, set this value to 1024. If your renders have noise, make this value even greater. To render, we select Render Image in the Render menu. Rendering takes place in a separate window. At the top, we can see information such as how many samples have been done. The remaining value is an estimate of how long the process can take. Once rendering is finished, don't forget to save the image by choosing the Save command in the Image menu. That's all I wanted to tell you about using the Cycles render engine for Live Home 3D projects. Thanks for watching.